House of Representatives has voted to expel Carlos Henriquez, the historic move coming just weeks after the Dorchester rep was sentenced to jail for assaulting his former girlfriend.
Henriquez made a final plea in the House chamber before the vote, but it didn't change many minds. News Center 5's Janet Wu is live outside the State House. Janet?
Well, the vote was 146-5. Carlo Henriquez, who is serving his second term in the Massachusetts House, was not allowed to vote on his own expulsion. Now, while the outcome was not surprising, some were amazed to find out that he was ousted on what some might claim was a technicality. With shackles and handcuffs removed, Carlos Henriquez walked up to the podium. He was snuck into the State House to avoid cameras after he complained of past photos of him entering wearing metal restraints. He told his colleagues he never attacked the 23-year-old woman he was found guilty of assaulting.
Although a jury found me guilty on two counts of assault and battery, it does not change my truth. However, I realize that my truth offers me some comfort during one of the toughest times of my life.
But House leadership insisted the guilty verdict says otherwise.
His recent criminal conviction indicates an impairment of judgment that is detrimental to the adequate representation of his constituency.
Amazingly, House rules say nothing about removing members convicted of felonies, so they removed Henriquez on a conflict of interest rule.
Independent judgment is about your ability to do your job properly. Independent judgment affects all of us. And like it or not, we are a body that is judged by perception.
Rule 16A does not fit the crime. So if we had a rule that says, and I believe we should have a rule, the rule should say if you're incarcerated, you shouldn't be in the House of Representatives. Today that doesn't exist.
Holmes argued on the floor of the House that Henriquez should only be censured instead of removed, but he lost that vote overwhelmingly.
I'm not sure if I'm more displeased by the process than the result. In any case, when the train is bearing down on you, it doesn't really matter if the light is red or green.
Now, Representative Holmes, who you just heard, argued for censure unsuccessfully, did say that Henriquez, his fellow colleague from serving Boston, should have resigned. We'll have